أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. Today inshallah we'll take part 2 of Surah An-Nisa. Just to recap the first part, the theme from Surah An-Nisa is justice and mercy, that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, in order to have a khalifa on earth, this and have support from Allah, this khalifa must have mercy and justice. Without mercy and justice, Allah will not support such a person and will replace him. So the first part of the surah talked a lot about the weak and the oppressed in a society. It talked about women, talked about orphans, talked about helpless people. So all of these were, you know, the common theme throughout all these verses is justice, mercy, or both. So in this second part, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala softens our hearts by reminding us of the justice and mercy that He bestows on us, that He shows from, you know, from Himself, you know, upon us. In verse 40, Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَظْلِمُ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ وَإِنْ تَكُ حَسَنَةً يُضَاعِفْهَا وَيُؤْتِ مِنْ لَدُنْهُ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. Indeed, Allah does not do injustice, even as much as an atom's weight. Allah will never treat us with injustice. He will always be just with us. And if we do something good, He will multiply it. So if we do something bad, it counts as one. If you do something, you know, something good, it's multiplied. That's out of His mercy and out of His bounty. And then in the next verse, in verse 41, Allah warns us that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be witness upon us and how we are just in this world. And the verse says, فَكَيْفَ إِذَا جِئْنَا مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ بِشَهِيدٍ وَجِئْنَا بِكَ عَلَى هَؤُلَاءِ شَهِيدًا. So how will it be when we bring from every nation a witness, and we bring you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, against these people as a witness? Now, a just and merciful believer is going to be happy with this witness. He's going to be happy that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is witnessing. But the person who's unjust, he's going to wish he'd never existed, because they, you know, nobody on the day of judgment would want to be in a position where he's accused of injustice. That is not a good position to be in. And then in verse 58, and there's another verse we'll talk about at the end of the lesson. These are very comprehensive verses. Verse 58 says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرْكُمْ أَن تُؤَدُّوا الْأَمَانَاتِ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهَا وَإِذَا حَكَمْتُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ أَن تَحْكُمُوا بِالْعَدْلِ أَن تَحْكُمُوا بِالْعَدْلِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ نِعِمَّا يَعَذُكُمْ بِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا. Says, Allah commands you. It's an order from Allah that we judge, that we render trusts to whom they are due, to addul amanat. So in our common understanding, we think amana, oh, I'm going to entrust you with something, you give it back to me. That's a very, very narrow meaning of amana. Amana is anything that is due to others. Your soul is amana. Allah give it to you and you have to return it. Your children are amana. Your, you know, when you work, when you accept employment, you know, your work is amana to your employer. So this is a very generic, you know, concept that anybody who has a trust upon you, you have to give it, you have to give it, you know, to give it back. وَإِذَا حَكَمْتُمْ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ أَن تَحْكُمُوا بِالْعَدْلِ. When you judge among people, you judge with justice, with Allah's justice, not what we think is right. There is, you know, Allah has clarified, this is what is right and this is what's false. So we have to judge according to justice. And later on we'll talk about another verse that stresses the same theme. So justice and mercy are embodied in this verse, and it's a very comprehensive one. So that's the best instruction from Allah tabaraka ta'ala. He is instructing us, be merciful and be just. And then the verses start talking about jihad. In verse 74, فليقاتل في سبيل الله الذين يشرون الحياة الدنيا بالآخرة ومن يقاتل في سبيل الله فيقتل أو يغلب فسوف نأتيه أجرا عظيما. So let those fight in the cause of Allah who sell the life of this world for the hereafter. And he who fights in the cause of Allah and is killed or achieves victory, we will bestow upon him a great reward. So what brings jihad to the theme of mercy and justice? Now, when oppression, and there will be always oppression on this earth, how are you going to remove it? The only way to remove oppression in some cases is by force. And that's what, you know, jihad is ordered, not to oppress other people, but to liberate them from, you know, from the injustices they're experiencing. So the next verse, verse 75, clarifies, you know, the order a little bit. وَمَا لَكُمْ لَا تُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَالْمُسْتَضَعَفِينَ مِنَ الرِّجَالِ وَالنِّسَاءِ وَالْوِلْدَانِ الَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا أَخْرِجْنَا مِنْ هَذِهِ الْقَرْيَةِ الظَّالِمِ أَهْلُهَا وَاجْعَلْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ وَلِيًّا وَاجْعَلْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ نَصِيرًا. And what is the matter with you that you fight not in the cause of Allah for the oppressed among men, women, and children who say, our Lord, take us out of the city of oppressive people and appoint for us from yourself a protector and appoint for us from yourself a helper. So, you know, many of the rules of fighting appear in Surah An-Nisa, that mercy and justice is the theme of jihad. When you're talking about fighting, the last thing that comes to mind is justice and ethics and having standards and having, you know, this high level of ethics. But that's how jihad is. And actually, qital, jihad is a different term. Qital is the fighting. Jihad includes fighting, but it's a much broader term that includes, you know, striving to improve yourself and striving in the cause of Allah in other ways. So, you know, the other verses, you know, verse 94, it says, you know, it's an order for the people. It says, when you go and you fight in Allah's cause, you know, make sure that, you know, فَتَبَيَّنُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا ضَرَبْتُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ فَتَبَيَّنُوا. If you go in fighting in the cause of Allah, you know, تَبَيَّنُوا. And تَبَيَّنُوا is investigate. ولا تقولوا لمن ألقى إليكم السلام لست مؤمنا تبتغون عرض الحياة الدنيا فعند الله مغانم كثيرة كذلك كنتم من قبل فمن الله عليكم فتبينوا إن الله كان بما تعملون خبيرا. Now this verse was in some battles, you know, when the Muslims would fight, and then when the non-believer is about to be killed, he says shahada, and then in one case the Muslim, you know, killed him. And the Prophet told him, no, you don't know what's in his heart. So that is the ethics that we have, is you cannot tell somebody, no, you're not a Muslim, so you can kill him and take his, you know, take his belongings. That is not the ethics that Allah put, and the justice that you know, when if you fight in Allah's cause, you have to have justice. You take people at you know, at what you see from them. You don't know what's in their hearts. That belongs to Allah. You judge people on what you see, you know, from their behavior. So you have to treat others with mercy even during fighting. And that's the ethics of war embedded in our faith. And, you know, then the next verse, then Allah shows mercy with the ones who want to do jihad, but they're not able. And, you know, verse 95, لَا يَسْتَوِي الْقَاعِدُونَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ غَيْرُ أُولِي الضَّرَرِ وَالْمُجَاهِدُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِأَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَنفُسِهِمْ. Now, Allah saying the people who fight are not on the same level as the people who sit, you know, sit at home and don't. But he excluded غَيْرُ أُولِي الضَّرَرِ, the ones that are physically unable to but want to, they're counted with the mujahideen, with the ones who fight. They get the same reward, and that's from the mercy of Allah, that, you know, he treats you based on your intention. You want to, but you can't. You know, physically, you're not able to. Allah gives you the same reward as the ones who actually go out there. But the ones who don't have an excuse and decide, you know, they're going to sit back and, you know, not do anything, those are are distinguished from the ones that actually fight. And Allah prefers the ones who strive in His cause. And then Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala addresses the weak, that, you know, okay, if you're strong and you're able to do it, you know, you should do it. But if you're weak and you're not able, there are things that you also should do. You shouldn't just say, I'm helpless, I'm going to sit here and not do anything. That is not Islam. That's the balance of Islam. Is Allah addresses those people in verse 97. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَوَفَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةَ ظَالِمِي أَنفُسِهِمْ قَالُوا فِيمَا كُنْتُمْ قَالُوا كُنَّا مُسْتَضْعَفِينَ فِي الْأَرْضِ قَالُوا أَلَمْ تَكُنْ أَرْضُ اللَّهِ وَاسِعَةً فَتُهَاجِرُوا فِيهَا فَأُولَئِكَ مَأْوَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمُ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Indeed, those whom the angels take in death while wronging themselves, the angels will say, in what condition were you? They will say, we were oppressed in the land. The angels will say, was not the earth of Allah spacious enough for you to immigrate therein? For those, their refuge is hell, and evil it is as a destination. But, you know, so the people that wrong themselves and they decide not to follow the path for one reason or another, but Allah makes the exception in verse 98. إِلَّا الْمُسْتَضْعَفِينَ مِنَ الرِّجَالِ وَالنِّسَاءِ وَالْوِلْدَانِ لَا يَسْتَطِعُونَ حِيلَةً وَلَا يَهْتَدُونَ سَبِيلًا. Except for the oppressed among men, women, and children who cannot devise a plan, nor are they directed to a way. So there are people that are truly helpless. I mean, they can't do anything. Those are excluded. But for people, it says, you know, if for example, I mean, this is one example of us living in this country. There are people who want to have a good living and say, okay, we're living in this country and we want to, you know, everybody deals with riba, so we're going to deal with riba because otherwise we're going to starve. We're not going to have any. No, this is you wrong yourself when you work like that. If you are oppressed in one part of the land, move to another part of the land. Don't jeopardize your faith and your principles, you know, to make a living. Allah's earth is wide. You know, go to another. There are many places where you can preserve your faith and still make an honorable living, and so on. So that's what these verses are trying to balance. So, you know, even for people that are helpless, they still have a duty on themselves to protect their faith and try to find a better, you know, a better situation. So everyone has a role to play in spreading justice and mercy. Nobody has any excuse that says, I'm helpless, I can't do anything. Everybody does according to what they, you know, what they can. And then in verse 101, the verse for shortening the prayer appears. That Allah says, if you're traveling, you know, you can shorten the prayer. And that's from the mercy of Allah you know, He's showing us how merciful He is with us. So we have duties, you know, to Him, and He's giving us leeway that if we are in position of, you know, difficulty and we're traveling and things like that, that He gave us some, you know, some license to take, and that's from His mercy. And then in the same surah in verse 105, it starts talking about mercy and justice with minorities. This is in an Islamic, you know, majority, the minorities, even though they're not Muslim, they have rights and they have to be treated with justice and mercy. Verse 105, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ لِتَحْكُمَ بَيْنَ النَّاسَ بِمَا أَرَاكَ اللَّهِ وَلَا تَكُنْ لِلْخَائِنِينَ خَصِيمًا. Indeed, we have revealed to you, O Muhammad, the book in truth, so you may judge between the people by that which Allah has shown you, and do not be for the deceitful an advocate. Now, this verse was concerning three Ansari brothers. Their brother stole a shield, and they covered for him, and they accused a Jew that he did it. And Allah revealed a verse to say, no, you know, there is, you know, justice has to be done. There is no difference between justice to Muslim or a non-Muslim. Justice is justice. It applies to everyone. And that's how Allah designed it. So when you have a society, justice applies to everyone. There is nobody above the law. And then verse 112, it gives a warning to people who do injustice. وَمَنْ يَكْسِبْ خَطِيئَةً أَوْ إِثْمًا ثُمَّ يَرْمِي بِهِ بَرِيئًا فَقَدْ احْتَمَلَ بُهْتَانًا وَإِثْمًا مُبِينًا. The ones who commit a crime and then blame somebody else are going to have, you know, blame an innocent person, they take upon themselves a slander and a manifest sin. It's a very big matter to accuse somebody, you know, wrongfully. And then there's a few verses that talk about hypocrites, and you know, because hypocrites are one of the dangers in a society. I mean, they cause a lot of problems in a society, and it's a threat. And Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is saying that the innal munafiqina fi ad-dark al-asfali min an-nar wa lan tajid lahum nasira in verse 145. Indeed, the hypocrites will be in the lowest depth of the fire. They're going to have the worst punishment. And never will you find for them a helper. But it's Allah's mercy that He gave them a chance to repent. In the following verse, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَأَصْلَحُوا وَأَعْتَصَمُوا بِاللَّهِ till the end of the verse. So Allah makes an exception that if you stop, if you're a hypocrite and you stop and mend your ways and come back to Allah, then you'll find that Allah is forgiving and merciful, and you know, so you can come back to the fold anytime that you're ready to do that. Allah did not say, if you commit something wrong, that's it, you're done. And that's the expectation that Allah has of us on how we treat each other. If somebody wronged you and then they apologize and make up, that's it. That, you know, the matter is resolved. There's, you know, you should go back to being brothers and not hold a grudge, because you know, if you hold a grudge, then Allah is not gonna, you know, we expect Allah to forgive our sins, so Allah expects us to forgive other people's, you know, infractions. And then there's a beautiful summary in the verse that I mentioned before in verse 135. It's a similar verse that's very comprehensive. It says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُونُوا قَوَّامِينَ بِالْقِسْطِ شُهَدَاءَ لِلَّهِ وَلَوْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ الْوَالِدَيْنِ وَالْأَقْرَبِينَ إِيَّكُنْ غَنِيًّا أَوْ فَقِيرًا فَاللَّهُ أَوْلَى بِهِمَا فَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا الْهَوَى أَن تَعْدِلُوا وَإِن تَلُوا أَوْ تُعْرِضُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرًا. So this is a verse for the believers that you have to be just, even against yourselves, or your parents, or your relatives. There is no such thing as I'm covering up for somebody. The truth is the truth. If you're wrong, admit it. If you're, you know, if your parents are wrong, you have to, you know, your parents are wrong. There is no, you know, you can't sugarcoat it. Justice is justice, and it has to be done on everyone. So there is no room for special treatment when it comes to justice, and it applies to everyone with no exception. And then the final note on the surah is Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala chose very beautiful attributes of His to pepper throughout all the verses to show, you know, the themes of His justice and mercy and bounty with the believers. You know, you'll see Ghafuran Rahima, forgiving and merciful, Alim and Hakima, ever knowing and wise. He knows everything we're doing. Raqiba, observer, Hasiba, accountant. Shahidan, witness. Wakilan, disposer of affairs. Muqitan, a keeper. Qadira, competent. Alimun Halim, knowing and forbearing. Tawwaban Rahima, ever accepting of repentance and merciful. Aliyan Kabira, ever exalted and grand. Aliman Khabira, ever knowing and acquainted with all things. Afuwan Ghafura, ever pardoning and forgiving. وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَلِيًّا وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ نَصِيرًا. And sufficient is Allah as an ally, and sufficient is Allah as a helper. عَزِيزًا حَكِيمًا, ever exalted in might and wise. سَمِيعًا بَصِيرًا, ever hearing and seeing. وَاسِعًا حَكِيمًا, encompassing and wise. غَنِيًّا حَمِيدًا, free of need and praiseworthy. شَاكِرًا عَلِيمًا, appreciative and knowing. And these names kind of, you know, show the whole theme of the surah, that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala wants us to be just and merciful. And He's just and merciful with us. He knows what we do, and He will treat us with justice. And if we do something good, we have no fear that it's going to go unnoticed. Allah does not, He notices everything. He knows everything. So anything you do, even if nobody knows about it, Allah knows. And that's the important thing. Allah knows, He will reward you for it. So all of these beautiful names and attributes in the surah enforce that, that theme. And then the final thing I want to mention is the name of the surah was called An-Nisa, the women. Because the women are, like I mentioned last week, are a symbol of the oppressed and the weak in a society. And whoever is able to treat women with mercy and justice, he can do it. He can do mercy and justice with everyone. So that, that's from the importance of that interaction between, men and women, husbands and wives, and so on. So that is why the surah was named after An-Nisa, to remind us to be just, with women and to have mercy on them. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will have mercy on us. Allahumma allimna ma yanfa'na wa anfa'na bima 'allamtana wa zidna 'ilma wa arina al-haqqa haqqan warzuqna ittiba'ahu wa arina al-batila batilan warzuqna ijtinabahu waj'alna mimman yastami'una al-qawla fattabi'una ahsana wa adkhilna bi rahmatika fi 'ibadika as-salihin subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.